When Copilot AI was here on the desktop, I was thinking, I don't need it here. I wanted to disable it. But after we update Windows on the latest version, 23H2, Copilot disappeared. The reason why Copilot disappeared, it's because there is some issues with that. Windows device using more than one monitor may experience some issues with desktop, and when you have two monitors like I do, Copilot confuse, and Microsoft removed for this version to bring it back in the next update. But you know what? I miss Copilot AI, so let's bring it back. Let's enable right now. I am Daniel from Tips to Fix, and in this video tutorial today, I'm going to show you how to enable and disable Copilot on your Windows 11 latest version. We are on 23H2. So first of all, without doing any movement, what is Copilot? Copilot in Windows is an artificial intelligence assistant that integrated with Windows 11 to enhance your productivity and creativity. Copilot works together with Bing Chat and ChatGPT plugin to keep you focused in your flow without needing to switch back and forth between apps. The first method that I'm going to try today is using Registry Editor, okay? Type here on the start, Registry Editor, and right-click, run as an administrator, okay? So now on the Registry Editor, we are going to go here, HK Current User, and then we are going here to Software, Microsoft, search for Microsoft, then go here on Windows, here on the Windows, then current version, then Explorer, go to Explorer. So here on Explorer, you have to search for advanced. So it's an advanced feature, okay? You will see Show Copilot button. So if you see this here, Show Copilot button, make sure this data will be one here. Just type one. Click OK. If this Show Copilot button is missing, then you have to create it. Right click here, click New, Dwarf 32-bit, and type Show Copilot button. And double click or just enter here. Type from 0 to 1. If it's already here, then it's 0. Then do it one, okay? So you have to make it one. Now the other thing that we are going to do is edit group policy. Search for edit group policy here. And here on the edit group policy, you are going to go here on administrative templates, user configuration, administrative templates, then Windows components. Then let's see here, Windows Copilot. If you see here Windows Copilot, then double click, we'll see turn off Windows Copilot. If it's enabled, it means that the Copilot will be off, turn it off, okay? So leave it as it is, not configured. Click OK now. Now I'm going to do a restart and see if this method will work, okay? So after I did the restart, I see that this method is not working. I mean, it's disabled. Now I will try another method. I will use this tool here on the GitHub, ViVeTool, okay? Let's download the latest one. I will download this, the latest one. Let's extract this first. Here, right click and extract. And I will copy this on my C drive. I have to have here on my C drive. Go ahead on this PC, on a C drive, and I will bring it here. This is the folder. Go to start and search for CMD, right click on the CMD, run as an administrator, you will see a pop-up. We need to go on this folder. Let's copy this path, okay? I will type CD and right click here on CMD, you will see, and click enter. Now I'm on the folder. Copy and paste this command, you will find on my website. Click on the link on the description, then copy here and bring it here. Click enter. So now we successfully set this configuration. So now let's do a restart and let's see. After restarting computer, here it is. Copilot is here. It's back here, guys. Now let me click and see this command works. Oh, look at this. I have to move myself here. Okay. So you see now? Let me write something. I miss you. I'm sorry, but I don't think I know you. So, okay, I'm going to close now this Copilot from here. Let's say if you don't want it anymore here on Task Manager, right-click on the Task Manager, you will see Task Manager Settings. You will see Copilot Purview. You have the option here to turn it off, okay? Turn on, turn off. So let's say you wanted to undo what you did, okay? So what we are going to do again, let's go here on the C drive. And you will see here ViVeTool. Go and open up this folder again. I will copy the path. Go to start and then click CMD, right click, run as administrator, and now copy the path of ViVeTool, type here CD, right click, here we are on the folder, okay? Is the same command, replace this from enable to disable, copy, you will find this command on my post, on my website, right click, click enter, and then you successfully set the feature to disable Copilot. So this is how you can enable and disable Copilot. I will restart computer and see. So now you see, it's not here anymore, okay? Now what I'm going to do, right click, let's see on the task settings, personalization, taskbar settings, then the taskbar items, Copilot is not here anymore, okay? So now let me show you how to disable from registry editor and for group policy. What I'm going to do, just click start group policy, edit group policy, enter, go to administrative tools here, you see, user configuration, administrative tool, system components, Windows components. Then here on Windows Components, you will see Windows Copilot. Turn off Windows Copilot. Click here Enable. Then Windows Copilot will be off. Now let's try with Registry Editor. Go to Start. Go to RegEdit. You have to go here on HK Current User. Software. Here, Software. Microsoft. Then Windows. Current user, Explorer. Here on the Explorer, we have Advanced. And here on Advanced, you will see here Show Copilot button, and then make this value 0. Then now, click OK. So that's it, you are done. So if you're stuck on Windows 10 and you're saying, okay, there is no chance now for me to install Windows 11 on my computer because it's old and my computer doesn't meet the requirement, there is hope for you guys. I did another video tutorial, click here, the video here that you see. In this video here, I'm explaining step-by-step how to install Windows 11 23H2, the latest one, on unsupported computers. And also for all of you guys that your computer is okay and it meets requirement, but you don't have the new update yet. If you don't want to wait anymore, then here it is in the next video, how to update your Windows 11 on the latest version, okay? So if you didn't subscribe yet, please don't forget to subscribe, tips to fix, and hit that like button and the ring bell on for all notifications, okay? So thank you again. Thank you for watching this video tutorial. God bless you. See you on the next video tutorial.